What is up, YouTube? This is the JP3 Games, and welcome back to episode 4 of my Pokemon FireRed Randomized Nuzlocke. In today's episode, we're going to make it through Mount Moon, and that is the main goal. We're going to get our fossil, get the encounter from Mount Moon, and then once we get to the other side, we'll end off there. But one thing I do have to say, in the previous episodes, episodes 2 and 3, I did suffer a little bit from audio issues. I had just moved everything over to a new computer, and I forgot to adjust my desktop audio, so it kind of drowns out my commentary big time, so you can't really hear me at all, hardly. But those episodes are out, so go on over and check them out. So let's go ahead and do a team recap, because I did do some off-screen grinding. So we start off with Steven the Remoraid. He's at level 16, he's got the White Smoke ability, and he's just rocking Water Gun and Lock On. Next is Speedy the Macargo, who we got in our Static Magikarp encounter from the last episode. He is rocking the Blaze ability, which is pretty convenient being a Fire-type Pokemon. And he is rocking the moves Yawn, Smog, Ember, and Rock Throw. Next up is our starter, Jeffrey the Sfeel. He's got Powder Snow, Ice Ball, Defense Curl, and Water Gun. He's got the Pickup ability, which is coming in super handy. I think I realized every time he picks up a TM, it's TM10, which is Sharpen, so we're never going to use that, which gives us the opportunity to sell it and have extra cash. But he's also been picking up PP ups too, and those are also good for cash, and will come in the long run if we get something with low PP. Everyone is at level 16. We also have Selene, the Lunatone, who we met in Route 3 in our last episode. She has the moves Tackle, Harden, Confusion, and Rock Throw. And then we also have Sally, the Ferret. She evolved in the last episode as well. So, we have Scratch, Defense Curl, Quick Attack, and Fury Swipes. She has the Overgrow ability, which is completely useless. Lax Nature. And then last but not least, arguably the MVP of the team so far, Teddy the Ursa Ring, who has Insomnia, Prevents Sleep, it's great. Rocking moves Scratch, Leer, Lick, and Fury Swipes. So the first thing we're going to do in this episode is get our Mount Moon encounter. So let's see what we can get in here. Yeah. Alright, come on. And it is going to be Alombre. Alright, not the best, but I will take it. For sure, we will go out to Teddy real quick, hit it with a few licks, weaken it down, and catch this bad boy. Why? The crit! This man is insane. Alright, so, Teddy's a savage. There goes our encounter for Mount Moon. But, let's proceed on. TM40 contains Wish. Let's see what else we could have got in this Zubat in Mount Moon on a randomizer. How fitting. I probably won't waste my time battling too many wild Pokemon, just for the sake of getting through this episode, but we will be battling all the trainers. Trapinch, that would have been nice. I would not have been upset with the Trapinch. Flygon is OP. Got a Ferret, Stamp, Water Gun. One more in that. Chinchou, we will switch out to. Switch out Sally here. And quick, and I saw Jeffrey has an item, so we are gonna pick that up real quick. Let's see the bag. I can't pick the item again. Take that. And Rossberry, come in nicely. A curlier, that would have been beautiful too. Steven Bear's level 17. Now let's move him out of the front. Let's put Speedy in the front right now. So yeah, but all of my recording and audio issues are worked out now. So we should be good to go from here on out. Next week I should have my webcam in, so I will be starting soon with the PokéCrate unboxings once I get my one for November. I talked about it in the last couple episodes, but you know, you can't hear it, so all that commentary was lost. But basically what I was saying is, with this PokéCrate, I plan on continuing to do this monthly. I will link all their information down below, so you guys are able to go and purchase those for yourself, or whatever you, purchase for a family member is a great gift. Like, I've gotten two so far, and I have been super excited about it. And the other thing I'm probably going to do, I'm going to do probably an unboxing of, I get the Loot Gaming Crate as well. So I thought about doing that. That was weird. Enigma berry. We got lots of berries here. Here's Snorlax. Let's put you to sleep. Rockthrow. Yeah, we'll keep you on Rockthrow because the special defense is way up. If we can land one. Nothing. Eat up all that XP. Oh, I didn't even see what's coming out. A Groudon. Yes, you know. I think we should go out to Teddy. Okay, I'm not going to use speed up because this is scary, even though we're 5 levels above Mudshot. Okay, that only does 10. Where's my speed? This man is slow now. One more scratch should do it, and we'll get out of this safely. But yeah, alongside this Nuzlocke, I plan on doing the PokéCrate unboxings and the Loot Gaming unboxings. I also might start doing a little bit of streaming. The new Call of Duty is coming out as well, and one of my buddies kind of wanted me to stream that on my channel. So I'm thinking about it, but I highly doubt I'm gonna do it. Might be something I do eventually. Then another thing I was gonna do. Crimson Invasion comes out for Pokemon TCG next week. I plan on ordering a trainer box and unboxing that on the channel. I think that'd be a good idea. And then there's actually the Shining Legends Super Premium Collection box that you can get. It's like $70 or $80 that I'm probably going to pick up and unbox that on the channel as well. Just because I want to get started with some Shining Legends, get the newest stuff, and I definitely could use the box itself as far as just a collector's item and for storage for TCG. But I've been slowly trying to get back into TCG. Just kind of gotta wait to get paid, because the cards are not the cheapest, unfortunately. But I do want to start entering tournaments and stuff like that. I know one of the local game shops here has occasional tournaments. They have pre-release tournaments, and they do play the meetup and play Pokemon TCG once a week there. So I eventually want to make my way there and kind of start learning, meeting more people, and getting back into that. I'm pretty excited about it. Alright, Teddy grows to level 17 to bring out Azurill. It's gonna be nothing. We'll send out Sally here just to kill it in cold blood. So, I actually just uploaded episode 2 to my channel right before I started recording this, and episode 3 is rendering in HitFilm right now. So, I probably drop that on Friday, which today is Halloween. Happy Halloween, by the way. I did not go out and dress up, unfortunately. I had to work, and then I decided to come record. So, definitely not a bad Halloween at all. Pinhead berry. Another berry. These berries are getting ridiculous. Let's go down here. Leaf, ignore you. Kakuna. Battle Team Rockets. Oh. As soon as I get my webcam and I start... I probably won't do it for this Nuzlocke, but in my next one, I definitely plan on having... Okay, that was a bad switch out. I should probably, like, quit. No. Oh, poison point. That's brutal. But as I was saying, definitely not for this Nuzlocke, but in my next LP, which I'm thinking about doing an Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon Let's Play, but I do have to, I actually have to buy the capture card for my 3DS, and I don't know if I'll get it back in time by the time the release date starts. I literally get paid in like 2 days, so I'm gonna check that out, and if I can, I'm gonna send it off and hopefully get it back to do an Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon playthrough on the channel. And then for that, I will definitely be having a layout and possibly doing a face cam. I've got a lot to learn about editing yet, so I don't want to get too ahead of myself and just kind of want to keep it simple right now. Yeah, so let's heal up Teddy. Let's see if we have any berries. Oh, we got Paralyze. Just a... Okay. I know I think I have an antidote. If I don't, this is going to be bad. Oh, yeah, it's right here. Thank God. Let's go ahead and use one of these potions. Use one on Steven as well. Get this item, Ultra Ball. That'll come in handy. Manectric. Confusion. But yeah, this is looking good. I've got a nice... Oh, it's got Trout. That's interesting. With this Nuzlocke so far. We don't have the most like powerful mons by any means. You know, Jeffrey, once he evolves, we just got to be careful with getting him there, because he isn't pretty fragile. But Ursaring is definitely like our most OP mon right now. Okay. This lady has an Entei. Let's go for Furious. Why, we're just gonna miss twice. We missed three times. Four times? Oh, okay, we gotta switch out. That is insane. Let's just miss four times. Oh, well, yeah, see? Teddy, MVP. Just taking down Entei's like it's his job. Curly, I will stay in for that. Look it up. Teddy is at level 18. Okay, we'll switch Steven back out front here. We'll heal up Sally. Fast. Keep making our way through Mount Moon. I always thought that was so weird how Thundershock, it doesn't affect ground types, but it affects rock types. I don't know. But loafing around, oh. Let's get this item. Eruption. Ooh. That could come in handy. A Tropic Man. Jesus Christ. Alright, so Eruption. I kind of want to teach it to Macargo, but I kind of want to wait because I know it's going to get Flamethrower. And it can't even learn it. Sally can learn it, though. That's weird. Oh, yeah, that's right, because it's randomized, and normally TM22 is... what is that? TM22, I think, like, Earthquake or something? No, that's 26. I don't know what TM22 is. That's the only thing I think I messed up when I did the randomizer, was I left the compatibility the same. So it was like, oh, hey, well, if it's TM32, double team... Or like, in the first instance when we beat the first Doom Leader, we got Bide, but it was Spark, so then everyone can learn it. I really hope this thing does not explode. Okay, good. Sheldon, switch out, go to Sally real quick. We'll stay in with Sally. Sally's got this under control. Vaporeon with Drizzle. We get an Eevee. I know what we're turning it into. Vaporeon for sure. I mean, Jolteon's always pretty nice. I always pick Jolteon, though, in the earlier games, but he never learned anything. Like, you got Thundershock and Pin Missile. You had to teach it Thunderbolt. We'll just leave it like that. Okay, let's, we're just gonna run away. Let me use a potion real fast. Okay, I'm trying to hurry up and get out of Mount Moon. I don't want to make this episode too long. We're about at 20 minutes right now. So hopefully have it under 30 and... uploaded for you guys. See, this is the only thing, is my team is so weak to fighting, it's ridiculous. I just have to be happy that I'm faster and have psychic type as well. Aerodactyl. I think our best... Oh no, we could use... Steven's got water gun. That does a lot. I don't want to risk the crit. Alright, let's move, let's put Speedy up front. Get this item over here. And it's, let's kill you real quick. A nugget, nice. We will sell that. It didn't let me escape from the cast form, that was funny. There's always an item right here. A lax incense, what does that do? Slightly reduces the foe's accuracy. Let's give that to... Give that to Celine right now. Corsola. That would have been nice to have. Oh! I almost forgot. I uploaded a picture on my Twitter. When we were grinding for this episode to get everyone up to level 16, I actually ran into a shiny Hitmonlee. And I uploaded a picture of it to my Twitter. So if you're not following me on Twitter, go follow me at Twitter at TheJP3Games. It was pretty sweet. I got super excited. I thought about catching it, but I was like, ah, no, I'm not going to catch it. I'm like, it's just a shiny. You know, no big deal. I'll probably get roasted for it later, but... battle you. Tyrogue. Okay, this is a bad matchup. I'm gonna have to go in something. Tackle. I don't think Tyrogue knows any fighting moves this early. He's got at least no karate chop or seismic toss or something. But it doesn't matter. Just had to fight off a sneeze. Oh god, that's terrible. Wow, that was intense. Preschooler Jacqueline converted to the Team Rocket. A Houndoom. No way. That's insane. Level 18 now. Let me bring Steven back out front. We can get some of that XP. Okay. That's crazy. See, I think what it did with this randomizer, like, I was just, like, going, like, way in depth. Like, I think every, like, level of a cave has different Pokemon. Right here, we're gonna beat this rocket real quick. But that's okay, I mean, you know, the more opportunity you have, you the better. Skiploom's probably gonna have Zillurp, I think I'll switch out. Crobat will stay in. I really hope Steven learns something else besides Water Gun and Lock On. He's like, while Water Gun is good, that's literally all he has. Like, no other balance whatsoever. Battle this nerd. Preschooler Marshall. Fun fact. Name Marshall. from How I Met Your Mother. How I Met Your Mother is one of my favorite shows. This is risky. I'm gonna heal. Scratch. Let's water gun. Okay, we should be good. Yeah, but How I Met Your Mother is one of my favorite shows, and I am so upset that Netflix is taking it off on November 13th. Like, I literally almost cried. I was so upset. Of some more original nicknames. These are pretty bland. Alright, we'll each take a fossil. Deal, bro. Use this paralyze heal real quick. We want Lord Helix himself. Now, when we get to Cinnamar Island, this Helix fossil is considered a static encounter. So we can use whatever Pokemon is inside of it. A red shard. Remember back in the days when you played Pokemon Yellow, you'd come up here and you're like, oh, where's all the Team Rocket members? And then you get to the end and Jesse and James Meowth show up and they're like, prepare for trouble, make it double. And you're like, nah, get out of here. Like, I really wish they would make, I was hoping for the 20th anniversary they were going to do a remake for Pokemon Yellow. But they did not, and I was so upset. But I'm hoping, since they said the main story is coming to the Switch now, that either Pokemon Yellow will get a remake and go on the Switch, or Diamond and Pearl will get a remake. Those are kind of the two I want remakes of right now. But definitely getting a Switch here next month sometime, so I'm looking forward to that. We will definitely be playing some Mario Odyssey, some Breath of the Wild, probably Fire Emblem Warriors, maybe Dragon Ball Z, you know, whatever else is coming out. It's Pokemon Tournament. Alright, we should be able to learn these moves. Nightmare. I don't want to learn that. And Water Sport. Ah, oh, that's a... Water Sport could come in handy, though. I feel like I could teach that to... Rimmerade can learn it? No, of course not. Just Teddy can learn it. This is gonna end up like someone's gonna learn a move and it's gonna be broken. Yeah, Teddy's gonna learn both. Well, no, he doesn't have Yawn. I was thinking, I was like, if First Ring had Yawn, then it'd be sunny day. What's actually, which route is this? This is Route 4. Four? Yeah, Route 4. So we can get a new encounter here. Let's go ahead and do that to end the episode. A Murkrow. I am not upset by that. But unfortunately, who would I take off the team? I would probably, honestly, I don't think I'd take anyone off the team for Murkrow, because Murkrow can't evolve into Honchkrow. Hopefully this Water Gun's not gonna kill. But that's good. I just got a notification. My boy King Corphish is live right now, so... I mean, he won't be live whenever you guys see this, but go check him out. Great dude. He did a sleepwalk a couple weeks ago, and he would have won it, and his power went out, and that is the most brutal thing, like, as a content creator you can experience. Like, I felt so bad. I eventually want to get to that point to do a sleepwalk, and it would be intense. And when we do a sleepwalk, it is definitely going to be a game that we can use a speed up button in, just to make it a little easier. But I would probably do... But if I did a sleepwalk, I would probably do platinum. Okay, this might really be difficult. He doesn't want to get in the ball. I don't want to waste this Ultra Ball on a Murkrow. You know what? I'm gonna go. I don't know why I didn't think about this sooner. Let's go out to Macargo. Zion. Just double yawn, so it's asleep now. Throw a Pokeball. One, two, three. Oh, you dick. Oh, it's a girl. Well, you're still a dick. Just get in the Pokeball. One, two. This gal does not want to join my team. This is crazy, I do not want to use all these Pokeballs on Murkrow. Wow, we were having such bad luck. Is there anything I can do to get it down lower? I don't think there is. Yawn. How much does Smog do? 20? Is it special? Eh. I don't think there's anything I can do. Let me see if I can switch out the Teddy using Intimidation Factor. Oh, it worked out. Let's just throw a Pokeball anyways. Hope for the best. This is crazy. What is Murkrow's catch rate, my dudes? I do not want to waste all these Pokeballs. Oh, come on. This is insane. I'm about to just use this Ultra Ball. This is crazy. Finally. It only took 13 Pokeballs. Somebody look up what Murkrow's catch rate is and leave it in the comments down below. I want to know because this is bothering me and I don't feel like looking it up right now. But we have Murkrow, and in honor of it being Halloween, and it being a female Murkrow, we are going to name this lady Wednesday from Wednesday Addams, from the Addams Family. I feel like that's pretty appropriate, as long as that'll fit. Yeah, it'll fit. Alright, we have Wednesday the Murkrow, and she's going to go to the PC, and she's probably going to stay there because... Did not enjoy that. Did not enjoy that. And we are in Cerulean City. I'm trying to think, where... We could get the old rod here. Correct. I don't know, we'll explore in the next episode. But I'm going to heal my Pokemon. And with that, I'm going to get out of here. So, if you guys enjoyed this episode, please comment down below, leave a like, and subscribe to my channel. And if you're not following me on Twitter, go follow me at TheJP3Games. See you guys. Peace.